Yo, welcome in everybody. We in there like swimwear. We're gonna be trying something a little different. We're gonna react to some fails, just watch some fails and see if any of them will at least make us laugh a little bit. See if I can give a little bit of insight. It's all gonna be boating stuff. I do work at a marina, so I got a little bit of insight on some of this, but it's always interesting to see. I've seen some crazy stuff at work. Yeah, let's just see how this thing goes. Starting off good already. That's a good one. Oh no, come on, me. Yeah, that's what I see a lot, man. People panic and their boat just keeps going. They just let it keep on going. Oh, she's definitely falling over. 100%. What is this guy doing? Looks like he's already in the wrong channel. I don't think he's supposed to be in a residential channel like that. He's taking out all their docks.
What?
Oh, yep. Everybody's coming outside mad, trying to figure out what's going on. Yeah, and it sounds like he's still under power. I mean, you can see the water behind the boat. Looks like he's still driving for it. I don't know if he fell asleep, just went the wrong way, and is trying to overcorrect. Like, you've seen how the boat was turning to the left. Looks like he's at a dead end anyway. But you see how the water's being pushed behind him. He was definitely still under power, which doesn't make sense. This one here, I've seen this shit a lot. They want to launch where there's not a lot of people, and they don't want to use the launch ramp, so they'll go somewhere soft and get themselves stuck. I've seen trucks all the way up to the chassis, man, can't even open the doors. Yeah, I would suggest to going back till you get some traction and maybe follow the shoreline a little bit so you can get a little bit of speed and then cut it left and get up the bank, but I don't know. That's just me. I don't even know if that would work either, or if he has the room for it. I do know he's gonna get stuck. Come on, man, I believe in you. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Hey, he did it. Hell yeah, good for him. Oh, that looks like an actual launch ramp. It's just sand. That's always good. Yeah, a lot of things are slippery when they're wet, man. Chasing the fish in reverse? What is he doing? Did he just sink the boat? Oh no. Oh no. I bet you he still has the pole. Yeah, a lot of guys will go over like that and they'll still be holding on to the fishing pole, getting pulled down. And look at that, out in the open water like that, you lose sight of that dude so easy. That's how it'd be out there. Yeah, I wonder if they're even gonna find him. Yep, wear your sunscreen. all I can say about that part. Very sensitive. Oh, this dude is beached.
Keep rocking it. He's rocking it. Oh, he's kind of moving.
No, no, no.
Oh, now he just stuck it.
Nah, best thing to do, man, is get your boat floating a little bit, swing it around to where you can get it to actually float, and then push it out far enough so that way your motors aren't hitting the ground. Just basically dragging all four of them motors to the sand. Oh, now he's going
backwards. Yeah, it's like he's going. But you know, the sandbar is deeper on that end. If you can go.
Oh, you got this one over here. Try it again.
Yeah, look, you can see how shallow it is. They're just standing there. I've had that happen.
Oh, let's zoom out because we got the other dummy. He's stuck again.
I go out to tow somebody in or help him get him stuck, and I go out there and they're standing next to him. It's only knee deep. Yeah, because now the motors are on the
bar. Oh, I wonder if these poor people swimming in the ocean.
Yeah, I've seen this a lot. I mean, polarized sunglasses help a lot.
He's really digging it in.
For anybody and everybody out there on the water, you can see a lot of that stuff before it becomes a problem. Yeah, that's another problem too, is that right? There's drunk friends telling them what to do.
Hey, bud. You forgot your boat trailer back here.
Oh, no. How is the boat hooked to the truck? That is just crazy. Tanker truck with a bunch of oil leaking out behind it. Could be something else, but looks like oil. I guess it would be in front of it because it's drifting that way. That's insane. Yeah, I've seen people drive right into the lake.
That's fine.
Oh, people don't know how to back up. Or pull through, apparently.
She just hit another car.
Oh, wow. She's just running into everything on her way through. Oh, yeah. A lot of people don't understand how big their stuff is, and they just keep going.
She hit a tree.
Look at that. She's running into everything. You got to give your shit enough room, man. Oh, yeah. Now, she ain't going very far. Yeah. Look at that. Busted. Pretty good damage. Hope she's got insurance. Yeah, people coming in way too hot, not motoring properly, so, you know, they should have been in reverse a long time ago. And then, look, now they're going in reverse too quickly because they held it in. They're going to hit something else now. Then they're going to go forward, probably hit something else, because they're not motoring right, man. Like, it's like driving a car with no brakes on ice. So, a little bit of throttle will go a long way. You can always go faster, but you can't always slow down. That's what I try to tell everybody who rents for me. It just be like that. So, my opinion, since, I mean, it is a sailboat, probably got a small motor. Keep it a little bit here, a little bit there. Keep yourself away from the obstacles. Oh. The drive shaft break or something.
Run.
And now it's just gonna roll. Yeah. Isn't it? Oh, and the boat's pulling away. Oh, both still too. It's just a bad angle. But anyway. Let's see, one more rock and it's on its way, I bet. Yeah, there's only so much you can do, man. There goes. That's an expensive fail there, I bet. I don't even know what this is. Oh, it's two of them. Rope wrap. Yeah. That's dead on. Alright. So that's all I'm gonna do on this one. Appreciate y'all stopping by, saying hi. We gonna end this one there. Move on to the next one. Alright. So like I said, thank y'all. And hopefully I'll catch y'all on the next one. Peace.